Millions of years ago, the Stegosaurus and the T-Rex roamed my neighborhood on the Earth in search of stardom. But it wasn't until 1993 when they finally got their big break. Jurassic Park was a massive hit when it stomped onto the big screen nearly three decades ago. And guess what? Now you can experience the prehistoric picture at Hudson Fields in Milton.
Yeah, Rob Rector is joining us via Zoom to talk all about Jurassic Fest. And Rob, I'm going to ask you to take us back to 93 when I didn't see Jurassic Park and still haven't.
You have not seen, well, Lisa, are coming.
I know.
I'm going to put a blanket front and center for you. You need to experience it on as big a screen as possible. You know, it Steven Spielberg once again kind of redefined summer theater going with Jurassic Park. He did it about two decades prior to that with Jaws, 1975, and, you know, the same kind of concept, but with a little bit older of a predator. And, you know, he changed the landscape again. And honestly, those images from a 30-year-old film still hold up.
Hmm. So you need to go see it, Lisa.
I got that.
So Rob,
you experience it.
Yeah, right. Yes, experience. That's the right word. So you already mentioned that this is an image behind you from Jaws Fest. What made you go to Jurassic Fest?
We obviously wanted to do an event. You know, when you have a big screen like this, and it's almost a 50-foot screen, 48-foot screen, you want something that people are going to feel, like, right, you know, that they're going to really. It's just going to envelop them no matter how large of a field they're on. And that's, you know, we automatically thought, hey, that's the next logical step, is something like Jurassic Fest that can be seen by everyone in the family, that everyone's invited to, you know, come, and it's free. You know, that just seemed like the next logical film for us.
Yeah.
So tell us about what folks can experience. I mean, you get the movie, but I mean, you're saying this is Jurassic Fest.
Right, Jurassic Fest. So it is. The doors will open, the gates will swing open, as it were, to Jurassic World there in Hudson Fields in Milton, Delaware, at 5 p.m. We're going to have live music. Hope for Success, who I believe has appeared on your program mm-hmm. before, they will be performing. We have a number of food trucks there. Arts and artisans. In fact, Cam Productions, who does the Horseshoe Crab 302, designed a new t-shirt for it. Revelations had created a beer for us. So it's going to be, you know, kind of all-encompassing. Games for the kids, face painting, and free. It's a fundraiser, so you pay what you want at the door, that's all.
Okay, so remind us, what is the mission of Revival House?
Revival House is just a big sandbox that Rob Waters, who is a filmmaker, owner of W Films, and I, we like to make cinematic events, whether they be events where people can participate, or competition where we give away prizes, and the Milton Theater has been our home for the past 4 years, and obviously, you know, we've readjusted with the pandemic, but we are going to be returning there very shortly, news to come. And in the meantime, we still wanted to be able to experience film, because it's, you know, that's one of the industries that got hit the hardest by this pandemic, and it's one of the experiences that I personally miss the most, that feeling of being with a group of people and experiencing a film.
All right, so Jurassic Fest, it's coming up. We'll have all the information on our website, delmarvalife.com. Rob Rector with Revival House, also film critic. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon.
Absolutely, and the Stegosaurus says hello, Jimmy.
Thank you.
Used to be your neighbor.
Yeah, I
appreciate it. Says hi.
Stop eating my flowers, it'd be good, but just saying.